There's one element on your homepage or on your landing pages that can make your page look either very professional or really hurt your conversions. And today, in this video, I'm going to show you how you can do it right. Hi, my name is Hanne from Thrive Teams, and the element that I'm talking about is a background image. Each time when we do reviews, when we look at landing pages, when we look at home pages, we see the same thing. Background images are hard to get right. Now, when I talk about a background image, I mean one of those nice looking full width images where you can overlay a title on and your call to action button so that your first part of your page looks really amazing. Now, the problem is that often, unfortunately, it doesn't look that amazing at all. And I'm going to show you now in 4 steps how you can do this the right way. Now, first of all, let's go to a website where we can get free photos that you can use on your website without any attribution. And the one I'm using here is Pixabay, but there are others and I will list them below. So first of all, imagine we are looking for a picture for a nutrition, a health coach. And so here I did a search for vegetables. When I look at these pictures, we will have to make sure that we choose a picture that is actually good as a background image. What do I mean by that? Exactly like I said before, we want to be able to overlay this. So we want to have our most important text on this image, our benefit-driven headline. And this means that we have to pick an image that's as uniform as possible. We don't want images that have like very light and very dark parts in it, because then it will become hard to get this image to look right and to have our text actually stand out on the image. So when we scroll here, you can see that, for example, this type of images will probably be kind of difficult because you have like the really black and white. And the image that I picked, so I already downloaded it, is a very uniform image. Let me show you. As you can see here, we have some really good examples like this one, or even like probably these carrots could work. This is an image that I would stay away from because, again, this has like very, very bright colors and very different colors from each other. So this is the one that I picked as the wrong example because I want to show you what happens if you choose a wrong image. And this one is the one that I picked for the right example. So as you can see, it's very nice. We have different vegetables on there, but it's all kind of in the same tone color. So when you want to download your image, you simply click on it and here, download the image at 1920 pixels. 1920 pixels is the width that we recommend for your images because it will look good on almost every screen and you will have that really nice full width image effect. Now, once you downloaded it, so here just click on download, then you have to do the second step. We have to optimize this image for our website speed. So what you want to do is go to a website called Kraken, kraken.io, use their free web interface, so you don't have to pay for this. And now you can upload the image that you just picked. Now, as you can see, for these two images, Kraken reduced it by 22% and by 10%, so that's already a nice saving. You can now download the file, so this will open it, and from here you can save it as an image on your hard drive. Now that we have our image and that we have reduced the weight of the file, we can upload it to our website. So let's go to Pages, add a new page, and edit the page with Thrive Architect. Now, as you can see here, this is a normal page, so we still have the breadcrumbs and the title. If you are using a Thrive Teams theme, then you can simply go into your settings and you can hide these things so that you can use the header and the footer section on your page to start from. But because I don't know which theme you are using, we are simply going to start from a landing page. So from here, we can go to our page setup. Choose a landing page template, and we're gonna start from one of the blank pages. Let's take this one. Now, on this blank styled landing page, you already have a background section, for example, so we can simply use this one. Let's drag the empty one on top and have a look at how it's set up. So here, we want to make sure that we set this background section to stretch full width. So that's very important. and we'll change the minimum height once we upload the image. So from here, we can simply go to the background style and add the image. Now, one thing that I want you to do every time when you use a background image on your website is first of all, put a colored layer. Now, the reason for this is that even if your image takes maybe half a second to load, people will already be able to read the text that is overlaid on your image because you have the right color background. So here, for example, what we'll do is we'll simply add some kind of green background that will be in tone with the image that we're uploading. So let's make this some kind of dark green. It doesn't matter all that much, but we want to make sure that if our image is dark, and so we will use white text overlay on it, that we have a dark color underneath it so that when it starts loading, we can already read the white text. Now this dark green is okay. Let's apply. And now the second layer on top of this colored layer will be our image. So let's select the image here. And make sure to upload our crocant images, so our reduced width images. And here, make sure also that in size you select full size. If this would be set to medium or maybe large, you will have a pixelated image. So you don't want to do that. Make sure it's full size so that it loads the 1920 pixel image. Insert it into the post. And now you can see it got loaded. Now for the moment, let's keep it on stretch and let's not change this. I'll show you why this is later on. And just apply the image. Now in the background minimum height, we can simply change how much we want to show of this image. So usually what you want to do is make sure that this image takes up quite a part of your website. So let's say something like 700 or even 800 pixels. This is probably what you want for the big hero background image on your website. Now I will first of all load a headline on this so that you can see why we will do the next steps. So let's put a text element on there. Let's put a heading on there. And this has to be your benefit driven title. Now, if you want this title to be in the middle of your image, you can simply click on your background section. And from here, we can use this setting so that everything will be set in the middle. Now, as you can see, this title is not very readable. So this is absolutely not what we want on our site. Let's try what this looks like when we switch it to white. So let's pick the white text color. And this is the mistake that I've seen the most often when I look at homepages and landing pages, is that the title is not readable. And so what you want to do is go back to your background section and let's add another layer on top of this image. Now, as you can see, I'm not touching any photo editing tool. You don't need Photoshop. You don't need any other tool. You can do all of this in Thrive Architect. So let's add another solid color on top. Make it black. But instead of having this at an opacity of 100%, we want to lower the opacity. So as you can see, the image starts showing now. Now, this will depend on your image, how much opacity you want to give, but make sure that the title is really readable. So let's put this at, let's say, 70%. As you can see, we have our background image. It still stands out, so you can see what's happening on the image, but it's not taking up all the attention because you want to make sure that your headline is the thing that grabs the attention most. Let's simply preview this, and this is what it would look like on your website. Now, there's one last step that you have to take when you use this type of background images, and that is checking what this looks like on mobile. So first of all, let's have a look. When we switch to mobile, and maybe we'll make this title a bit smaller because it doesn't make much sense to have it this big. As you can see, we have like the soup board and just this spoon. Now, the reason that this happens is because if we go back to our desktop view and to our background section, We decided that when we had this image inserted, you can see here that the display is happening from the upper left corner. So everything will shrink from this corner and will shrink like this. So you will always have the upper left corner showing. Now, if you prefer to have this centered in the middle of your image and have it shrink so that it always shows the middle of your image, you can simply switch it here on desktop view, apply this, and now when you go to mobile, you'll see that we have our broccoli in the center of our image. Now, probably on mobile, you also want to make sure that you reduce this minimum height, because 800 pixels would really be a lot, and then this would become your title section. Now, one other thing that you could do is not have the image on mobile and simply have a solid color, and this will always help you to have your site load faster on mobile. Now, if you are looking to make the type of layout where you have a person on one side and then text on another, I made a completely separate tutorial for that. It's called Hero Image, so check it out. But if you were looking to do this full-size background image, then I hope that this will help you, that these four simple steps will make sure that you have good-looking background images on your own website. Now, let me know what you think. If you have any questions, please leave them below.